Ladies and gentlemen, boys, girls, children, pet mongooses, mongoose. I like mongoose. We'll go with that. Anyway, collective people of the internet. We got TugBoat. We got TugBoat in a T95. TugBoat's played 1,681 games in his T95 with a 53% win ratio. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking one of two things. You're going to see the unstoppable killing machine, or just the unstoppable. And I'm going to let you know right now, that's not really what you're in for. TugBoat sent me a very nice email, kind of giving an explanation as to what I should be looking at. And that's helpful. And it's kind of not really what you're used to or what you would think a T95 would do. And I haven't seen, as per usual, have not watched the replay ahead of time. So this is going to be new to you and me both. What I can tell you is that TugBoat is currently building himself a house, I believe, somewhere in the Boston area, the outskirts. I believe that's correct. And that he is currently experiencing certain issues in that regard. For instance, his internet will not be the best in the world. There's a 30B coming out to play. And just general, you know, first world problems. So, what we're going to do here is apparently go trash bag that JP2 that's in the bag. That's probably not accurate. Let's charge on in there. That's not really what we're going to do. What I've been told is that this is more of a positioning game. This isn't so much, here, look at me in the T95. It's more like, look what the T95 should be doing in this situation. For instance, you'll notice that all of our artillery is all clustered up in one area. You will also notice that two of the three artillery are platooned and are kind of good at their job. We sort of have... This is kind of a wheat from the chaff type situation right here. You'll notice that almost everybody who's dead already is okay at the game to not really that good at the game, and they're all playing fucking scouts. So all of our scouts suicided right away. Immediately suicided. Good day, sir. Oh! You gotta be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me right now. Well, CDC just suicided. So, yeah. All we need is our Pershing to go down and everybody below kind of, okay. Oh, Lord, love a duck. That's a good arc. You know, here I sit talking shit, not actually playing the game. I played a lot of Minecraft today. I had a random day off in the middle of the week and gosh darn it all to heck, I made some improvements around the house. Not my actual house. That's too much work. Just my Minecraft house. We've also got Ace Blue on the Minecraft server, who's apparently some sort of hidden Minecraft whiz. So, hey, there's the 30B. Wow, 30B is getting around. 30B was up above where the heavy ticks are now. Lord love a duck. So, we know where their heavy tanks should be. The 30B behind us is kind of a problem. And an IS-3 coming down. Alright. So, this is kind of the focal point right here. We gotta be in position. We gotta be able to stop things from happening. And or terrify the crap out of the majority of their team. They're down three tanks. And both sides have all the artillery, but they also have a lot of heavy tanks that we don't. We got a 30B behind us, we got a Yag Panther 2 behind us, we got a Roomba moving in on base, we got a Bulldog moving in on potentially our artillery. One of our artillery got counter-batteried. So that's good. The KV, oh lord, the KV-4 has come off of the flank and is now up the middle. Alright, here it comes. Surprise, motherfucker. Oh, Unleash the beast. Patton's going to go down. Ain't nothing you can do about it. We must seek revenge. If only we could pivot. Must turn. Dear Lord. He's gonna go all the way up the hill before we can get anywhere near him. Fuck me. It looks like our Pershing's putting a hurt on him, and it looks like the artillery is trying to help us out. Aha, nothing for you. Oh Lord, my face! And an IS-3 up the hill. This is less than ideal, however, T-95 OP. Oh, Pershing, thank you. Thank you, Pershing, we appreciate the, this is some crazy tango shit right now. If that IS-3 had half of a testicle, Tugboat would be really in trouble. So we got a Waffle 9 holding all of the forts. We got a Pershing covering, trying to cover the middle. We got Tugboat trying to fend off a 30B, and it's a good thing the IS-3 is plain old good-fashioned retarded. I'm not so much liking the gun sound noises on this. I'm used to a lot more. Oh my god! Yeah, that's what I'm used to. I like the ricochet sounds, but I don't like... I'm not liking the gun sound so much. There's no real sound to be had, unless they're right up in your face. I don't know where that IS-3 went. Probably to wash out his delicate unmentionables. Because radar? Why am I saying radar? Tugboat. Tugboat would be in real dramatic trouble right here if the IS-3 had an ounce of spine and, oh Lord. Wait, our Waffle House destroyed their artillery? What the hell's going on here? What did I miss? Oh my god. Hello? Where was that guy at? Wow, that dude pushed all the way out onto the flank. That's pretty amazing. Retarded, but amazing. Amazingly good for us. Also, our Vatcheds are kind of dropping bombs on people. And now we've gone from 3 tanks down to 1 tank up. We really need Ultra Scrub here to not do what he's doing. No. Oh, he's gonna make it? Is he gonna make it? No, he's gonna get greedy. He might make it. You know they have 2 artillery left, right? You do know this. You are aware? I don't know what he's doing. Except for scrubbing it up apparently as hard as it gets. What's this guy's deal? 5K games? Well, I guess that's some 5K game stuff. There comes a certain experience level where you know where to put your tank and you know how to handle it. And you know not to go out there and wait for the friggin' artillery to jump on your head. Just putting that out there as a thing. Now, one of our artillery is pushing out pretty hard. He's looking to probably go out there and maybe nail their artillery. Or scout for his buddy. Our Pershing apparently thought that going back and forth in a straight line and then parking with his ass to a giant backdrop was a great idea. Ideally situated to avoid A, getting shot in the side from the IS-3 or something, and B, right in the top of the... Actually, that was the back of the head. I think it was right in the back of the turret. Shekshe. Yeah, I don't know what that guy's doing. That guy, right there, that motherfucker. Parked sideways so that the IS-3 could shoot him, and also couldn't retreat because he's backed into a rock. Perfect, perfect, perfect for artillery to drop bombs on his head.
I don't understand it any more than you do.
Now, the majestic T-95 is stately and grandiose. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Look at all that stuff. Isn't that cool? However, it's very slow. So, we go and get a little chippy with it. Oh. What's going on over there? Oh! pwn. Very nice. Now, oh, I was going to speed it up again, and they found him. Who's going to get the kill? Is it going to be Sickage? Is it going to be Silent Killer? Dun, 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 dun. Oh, Silent Killer again. Very nice. Silent Killer for the win. And that is how you help your team. You don't need to fire a lot of shots. You just need to be big and scary. And you need to know where to be big and scary. So let's look at some final battle results. There's a lot of screenshots. I kind of had to whittle some out of there because not all the details were relevant. Shiny, but not always relevant. Let's have a look. Alrighty, got third class mastery badge and a spotter. Not shiny, not really impressive as far as metal camp goes, but that's not really what we're after here. We were basically just getting the win. We were down three tanks and we had to try and win, so that's what's up. 2,000 XP, almost 30 grand in the hand. Had some damage blocked, handed out a little damage. That's pretty much it for Tugboat's role. It was largely positioning and timing. Not so much carrying the team, just being that the big cog in the machine that, you know, all of the work gets done through. And he only got 610 damage, but the artillery got 2,100 and 3,400 between them collectively. Both got some damage that was like that. Great. The Waffle 9 actually was holding that flank pretty much on his own and did damn near 4,000 damage of himself. The Patton got almost 2,500. The CDC somehow got 1,500 before exploding. And the AC-48 got 1,300, almost 1,350 before exploding. And virtually everybody else just ran out, suicided, and went home crying. The Pershing Ultra Scrub needs work. I see some potential there. That's good. He was doing sort of the right thing and then just kind of hung his cock out there and got it stepped on. And yeah, there was really zero reason to go out there against any of that because they have to come to you. But that's nothing that he's going to hear from me in the grand scheme of the internets. So, their team did pretty well. Very few of them did anything completely wrong, except for the guy in the IS-3 who got zero damage and really, really, really could have made Tugboat's life a living hell, just raining down shots on him from an elevated position. However, he's apparently not good at tanks and drove way out in the open field and hung out and got the shit kicked out of him and all kinds of good stuff like that. So, we're looking at the Silent Killer. Silent Killer. He went 8 for 14 shooting with 5 splashes and 8 penetrations. So that's pretty, let's just call it pretty good, yeah? got 3,426 damage. Received 1 hit as a result of splash. Shot 6. Destroyed 5. Almost had himself a top gun. Pretty close. Even spotted 2 guys. I think he spotted the 2 artillery at the end. And as you can see from his statistics, he's pretty good at the game. He eyed. I mean, he's only got 1 pools medal. Like, you know. And only 8 Redley Walters. But, you know, it's all right. He's got more top guns than I do, though. Let's see. Sickage or Silkage? Is it Silkage? It's probably supposed to be Silk Age, but capitalization. Silkage. Went 3 for 8 shooting with 5 splashes. So that's really 8 for 8 shooting. Come on. 2,100 damage. Shot 4, killed 1. And he's pretty good at the game as well. Kind of good, you know. Use it with the Tang Dynasty. I wonder if that's like the Poontang Dynasty. Just questioning that. And for Tugboat... Why do I want to keep saying radar? I'm an idiot. I'm a moron. For Tugboat himself... I think I've been doing so many radar replays lately, it's kind of ridiculous. Went 2-for-3 shooting with 2 penetrations. Total damage of 610, not a big deal. Took 5 hits, 2 of them bounced, 3 of them did not, which is a little unusual for the 95, but he was completely surrounded. The number you got to be looking at is the damage caused with your assistance, which is 2,229. That's where the dividends come in. That's how he helped the team. He spent 12 gold. If I was him, you might want to change that over to credits, sir. just a thought. Got himself the 2,100 XP, made himself 20 grand as well, and really didn't have to do much other than be in the right place at the right time and put up a good front and enough effort. He really let the strengths of his team carry the game, and that's more or less what you got to do. And he's got 20 million credits, so if anybody wants to mug him in a dark alley, I wouldn't recommend it. He's got kind of one of those, you know, T95 things, and he might fuck you up. So, well done, sir. Well contributed to the team. And keep on trucking. Hope the house is coming together. Peace out. Peace, the love, and the death metal. And I see he's rocking Windows 10. Let me know how that is, actually, if you wouldn't mind, sir. Enjoy yourselves.